Australia and the world is not yet on track to achieve the Paris Climate Agreement goals to limit global warming below 2 degrees or 1.5 degrees. I really want to change that. I always had an interest in environmental issues, but the climate change part really strengthened during university, partly because the Kyoto Protocol was being negotiated and ratified during my university years, and because I was also doing a business commerce degree alongside my law degree, and a lot of the Kyoto Protocol was about trying to create market incentives, and so it matched very well with how can we use markets to help address environmental challenges like climate change. 10 years ago in Australia is when ClimateWorks Australia was established by Monash University with the Maya Foundation. And the reason it was set up was because there was a lot of concern about climate change. Businesses and governments who realised that they needed to act didn't have a source of trusted, objective, evidence-based advice, and that's why ClimateWorks Australia was established. The gap we've identified is often in the translation of knowledge, of taking the science and the technology into actionable plans for business and government, whether it be frameworks, roadmaps, policy change, analyses of which technologies have the best bang for buck in terms of emissions and cost effectiveness. We have noticed, particularly since the Paris Agreement was signed, there has been an increase in the quality of the companies asking our advice and the quantity of companies and governments asking. It really has shifted from if we should do this to how we should do this. Monash has been a fantastic partner for ClimateWorks, not only as our formal host and providing us with the institutional backing that otherwise as a small startup funded by philanthropy we would lack the access to all the institutional support that a high quality university can provide. But also Monash itself is committed to the net zero emissions goal and has now very high profile, $135 million investment to be an entirely net zero emissions campus and across all of its campuses. The deep decarbonisation pathway was a seminal work 5 years ago that ClimateWorks and Monash were involved in. It mapped for the first time, along with 17 other countries, how can nations actually achieve net zero emissions? And the good news is the answer was yes, we can do it with technologies that were already invented. And we're now updating that advice for how has technology improved in the last 5 years and how has the science got worse and does it still add up? And the solutions are still within reach. Just, we're going to have to move fast.